Hey, my name is Jason Spanu, DJ Shine, and now I'm going to talk a little bit about how I work with Stutter Edit and Ableton Live in a production environment on my own original material. So basically what I've got here is a song that's pretty much almost done. Give it a quick little listen. Got it sort of laid out in my session view. I've also arranged it somewhat. And I'm at the phase where I'd like to just add some, you know, some freaky new elements, a little bit of something to spice up some of the sounds. So the main sort of element of my song here is this, this analog synth I've got here. And what I want to do is maybe just plop an instance of Stutter Edit on that track. And maybe just pick, you know, something random. I don't know, filter splice sounds kind of neat as a preset. And I want to make sure I've got a MIDI track hooked up right next to it. And I want to take that information that's going to come from the MIDI track and make sure it goes to my Stutter Edit. So that's going to actually be on track 5, because that's where I've placed it. And I also, for this sort of demo, I'm going to be using my launch pad, which I've got in user 1 mode. And right now, if I just hit some notes, I can see that the information is coming in. I want to specifically say it's going to be coming only from the launch pad. You don't have to do that, just kind of how I roll. So let's give a quick little audition to how that will sound. So yeah, some kind of neat sounds in there. I think I'd be pretty happy with that. Now, I could just record the MIDI information and have that all happen in real time on the fly, but I also kind of want to record the affected audio separately. So let's create a new audio track here, and I want to make sure that I've got the information coming from channel 5 with that analog synth with the Stutter Edit. I'm going to arm that track, and now what I'm going to do is record not only the MIDI information that's going to be playing Stutter Edit, but also the affected sound as it passes through Stutter Edit on a new track. Okay, so hit record and play. So you can see where we've gone, and I did a pretty random, didn't sound like the coolest thing there, but I guarantee you it will be cooler. So I've got the recorded MIDI information of that first sort of attempt, and I've got the affected randomness of Stutter Edit, and I still have my original sound coming from the analog synth. What I'm going to do now is funkify it a wee bit more. I'm going to make a new track and tune that in again to be from Stutter Edit track, channel 5 here. Boom. So I want to capture the same idea, but this time I'm going to switch the presets in Stutter Edit and make it make that first recorded MIDI information apply to a completely new thing. So maybe instead of using filters, let's use the time warp reversal. So let's do that. Hit play, record. This MIDI information is already there. It is going to be playing Stutter Edit, and it's going to be captured on this track here. So that's kind of neat. Let's do it again. Another one, same idea, over and over again. Keep tuning it into the same track. Going back to that first Stutter Edit, and let's just grab something weirder. Generators, those are neat. They do some really cool things as well. So now, same idea, information flowing through, captured onto a new track. So So now we got is a happy little mess of sounds. I don't really need that MIDI information anymore. I'm just going to blow it away. And now we've got the original, the first pass, the second pass, and the third pass, all sort of combined. And if I just, you know, goose the signals here a little bit, maybe pan one to the left, one to the right, and maybe same over here. Now we hear all these together. Now, if I take that and start applying it over and over to different areas of the song, to see all of a sudden. We've got something a little three or four more times cooler than just using Stutter Edit on one track. We've effectively randomized and captured something that was a series of happy accidents, actually. You know, you can go back and say, you know what, most of this was kind of wrong, but I'm just going to grab, let's say, just the middle section of it, keep it all cool, and start sculpting the different sounds out. Like, that was a little out of control, so maybe I'll just, you know, peel that back a bit. This is where the real fun starts to happen, because you can actually edit your Stutter Edit, which really you can get the desired effect you want that came from a series of accidents. So this is how I work. One way of how I work, just because I'm excessively lazy. I think most people are. Well, maybe, but this just seems to work for me and give me something random, and I don't have to think too much about it. And that's one thing I like about Stutter Edit, is that he can really get a cool effect without thinking too much. I just use preset randomness. If I wanted to, I could definitely make my own. But it's more fun to just, you know, spin the roulette wheel of Stutter Edit and see what you end up with. So enjoy and try and apply some of this in your production work.